In the previous video, we saw that tag integration is easy. You just export a CSV file from the Do More Designer project and then tell Point of View where to find that file, which you would normally put in your Point of View project folder. In this video, we'll take a look at a couple things that you need to be aware of before using tag integration with a Do More controller. And we'll also cover a few general items that apply to all controllers. One of the cool things about the Do More is you can add as many structured heap items as you want, things like timers, counters, strings, PID loops, anything that uses the dot notation to select its member elements. You're not stuck with a fixed memory plan like you are in other controllers. You can add as many timers or PID loops as you want. The good news is, Point of View gives you access to those heap items you created, so you can use them in Point of View just like you would in the Do More. That's awesome, but there's a couple things you need to be acutely aware of before using tag integration with the Do More. First, each time you modify any portion of memory, add a tag, delete a tag, create a new memory element, create or delete a program or a task, add a heap item, anything that modifies memory, the Do More uses that as an opportunity to optimize memory usage, which means it moves everything around to best fit memory every time you make a change. So anytime you make a change, whether Point of View is going to use it or not, make sure you re-export the CSV file, or Point of View may not be able to find what it's looking for because there's no guarantee that the memory element will be at the same address as it was before. The second Do More specific caveat is if you use any member of a Do More structured heap item in Point of View, like this timer dumb bit, then Point of View will deduct the total member element count from your tag license. In this timer example, if we use this one timer done element in Point of View will reduce the tag license count by 5 because there's 5 elements total in this heap item. If you use a single PID element, like the set point, Point of View will deduct 19 tags from your license, and if you use a program element, like this program done bit, you'll lose something like 147 tags off your license because that's how many member elements there are in that structure. Now, if that's a problem for your project, then take a look at the next video on the main driver sheet. The main driver sheet gives you a way to use one element at a time without the entire structure element count going against your tag license. That's all the Do More specific caveats. Let's look at a few general items that apply to all controllers. You can't edit a tag that was imported using the tag integration method. What you import is what you get. If you need to change the tag, then you have to do it on the controller end and then export the tags again and tell Point of View to use that new file. If you think you will need to change tags manually in Point of View, then check out the next video on the main driver sheet. It'll show you how to do that. You can't automatically scale a tag in Point of View that was brought in via tag integration. Again, use the main driver sheet for any tags that you want to scale automatically as they come into Point of View. If you accidentally delete or move the CSV file so Point of View can't find it, Point of View will delete all of the tags if you verify the project or you select Remove All Unused Tags when you start the development software. In either case, all of the integrated tags will be lost and you'll have to start over. So make sure you keep track of where that CSV file is. One way to help avoid this is to get in the habit of storing the CSV file in your project folder. In the global view, you have the project-specific tags, which we haven't created yet in this project, the built-in system tags, and the shared tags, where you'll find the tags the project's sharing with the Do More controller. This project's using 4 Do More tags. If you want to see all of the controller's tags that are available to the project, then click on the Object Finder button, which is under the Home tab over here. Black tags are being used by the project and count against your tag license. Gray tags are available to the project, but they aren't currently used anywhere in the project, so they don't count against your tag license. If you need any help, please call Automation Direct's free, award-winning tech support during regular business hours. They'll be happy to help. And don't forget the forums. There are lots of folks there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post any questions directed at Automation Direct support team there. They don't monitor the forums on a regular basis.